Hi there, I'm Vaughan, Sivell, and I'm the director of Mr Calzaghe. I am a Welshman, and I'm a little bit younger and obviously much prettier than Joe. And when I got a call to say, are we interested in the company, because I run the company as well, are we interested in doing a Joe Calzaghe movie? I was like, well, of course, he's every Welshman's sporting hero, apart from a few rugby players. But I did have a sort of concern that, was there a story beyond the record that he had? And of course, one hour of looking into the weird story of Joe and Enzo meant that it was sort of cinema gold for us. And so I was in it, and then met with Joe, and we got on really, really well. And I just had two of the best years of my life following him around the world. So, well, I think the two things, his career record and his relationship with Enzo, are indistinguishable. I mean, obviously they are literally indistinguishable because he trained him his whole life, but the rarity of that in any sport, something as high pressured as boxing, where, you know, everyone says about boxing that it's sort of the bravest, most honest thing because you're alone, but your dad is in the corner telling you to get up, telling you to get in the guy's face again. And so Joe basically had a refuse to lose attitude his whole life, and it was beaten into him by Enzo. And when you're around them, they're infectious. They're just like, it's the most amazing energetic relationship. And I, from day one of shooting with the two of them, I just knew if we could capture that on screen, it would be something that people would feel the same as the whole crew did about it, who didn't know boxing, didn't know Joe and Enzo, and just was sort of enraptured by it from the start. And I honestly think if Joe had been with a different manager, he wouldn't have had the record he had, because Joe's a certain character and Enzo's a certain character, and together they are just an unbeatable team. So you can't distinguish the career from the relationship. I mean, Joe's just sort of your ultimate hero in that he's obviously, by chance, he looks the way he does. He looks like De Niro. And because of his fighting style and his impressive habit of not being punched very much. I mean, most people don't realise what a chin he had, but he still looks amazing, is the first thing. But I think more than anything is, like I said before, you can't watch the movie without seeing that this is a story of rags to riches, literally rags to riches, heart and soul, and it's a family movie. It really is a family movie. And it happens to be about a sport, happens to be about boxing. But for me, I always thought I was making a heist movie, really, because they were the most unlikely team to go into a really dirty sport and come out with the safe emptied and literally quit at the top and walk away and go back where they came from. Boxing went through a hard time, and, you know, one of the really key themes of the film is that Joe perhaps didn't get the recognition that his record and his career deserved. And that was because, of course, for a lot of us, boxing moved from terrestrial TV, where it was Saturday night entertainment, to channels that most people couldn't get. So when Joe would have been the biggest star on the planet, he wasn't, because a minority of people saw it. But you watch this film and you see how much heart and soul it is, and you see that there's no gimmicks, there's no tricks to it, there's no acting. It's working through the pain, getting punched in the face, coming back stronger, and doing it for the love of your children and your old man. He's a legend. Editing a career of 46 fights is, and 20 years in, you know, he's a 40-year-old guy when he's retired, is an almost impossible challenge. When you've got a story like Joe's, it's almost like adapting a perfect book for the screen, which is what no one wants to do. And my background is in theatre and drama, not in documentary. So we were really aware of the problems from the start, and it was basically realizing that various parts of Joe's life and career had chapters like any other story, and that if we focused on the importance of certain chapters rather than the train track, preparing for a fight, fighting, preparing for another fight, fighting, we would sort of have a film that did justice to the story, because it really is stranger than fact. For me, I think the courage to retire when he did and stay retired. Lots of people will say his fight against Lacey, his fight against Kessler, winning 3 ABAs in the way he did to break those records. But for me, and I think anyone who sees the film will agree, that walking away with all your money, with all your pride, and with your love of your family around you, and having half of your life left to live, is something that too few of our sporting heroes manage to do.
every kid, right, they got a sport, span, and Joe wanted to be a soccer player. And being I'm from Sardinia, you know, Zola's place, right, I'd born up in Sardinia. But obviously, I'd born up in Bedford as well, actually in Bedford. And football was my dream, always dreamt football. So in any case, Joe wanted to be a soccer player. But one particular day, they didn't pick him in school, right? For some reason or another, we don't know, probably biases, right? After Joe started came back home crying, Dad, you never picked me, never picked me. So I thought myself, okay. I had a cushion, big cupboard, where it is, in the house. So I bought him a punch bag, like this floor ceiling one. Joe said, start punching it, learn a bit of punching it. And he really enjoyed it. A funny thing about it, that there was we were in a new estate camp near the site, and down about half a mile, there was actually a gym. That's a fluke. Absolutely, just built out of the estate. And there was down the road, there was a boxing club. So obviously I took him to a boxing club, and he loved it. He loved it. I thought, bloody hell, brilliant. So from there onwards, obviously, he grew up to 8, 9, 10, and started enjoying the boxing there, right? And the story becomes then. He started winning ABA champions, ABA titles, ABA titles. Everybody's saying already, this guy is going to be a superstar. Only needs common sense about it. But obviously, I was linking with him. It's obviously I'm his father. But I like the training method. I learned him more. It's my training method. And today, as you can go on and talk, that's why and why. But he created this guy, which is a special type of boxer. They're not boasting. The world knows about it, right? And I myself never trained him myself. I was not a trainer. As I come nowhere, I didn't know nothing about boxing. I was a soccer player, a musician, actually, I was a musician. For some reason, it gelled together because obviously what I visualized is a style of different boxing, which obviously me and Joe happened to be gelled well in, and everybody enjoyed that style. But in any case, for us, it was very successful. And to this very day, that style remains unique. And obviously, we created and defeated Joe Calzaghe. Simple as that. The proudest moment in this thing is genius courage. They're very courageous, right? Listen, it wasn't a rose and glory. Let's make sure, right? He had 46 world title, not world title, but 46 undefeated, but he had 26 world title fights. They're going to be bleeping one there. Now, when it was true, there are world title fights, 26 world title fights in a row. Some way, I was never, ever scared. Never scared. That every title, we know, when Joe wins, when someone wins a world title, everybody's after your ass. They're after you to get the title off you. Correct? And what he did, basically, is he was confident. The word confident. And I was so confident about my ability to train him. That's where it gelled in well. But Joe knew his father wasn't his father on a fight night. I was divorced. I was a trainer, not a father. And I had that guts to say, I'm a trainer, not a father. I didn't have no intention to cry over him when he dropped. No way. I said, get up. Another trainer would say, another father would say, that's my father. That's my son. That's my son. No way. So that's the power that Joe wanted. He went to a trainer, that responds to his ability, which I did. And I think that's the reason now, honestly, Joe, we embrace each other as a family now, but that particular bearer is completely different. We had the heart of the family, has always been there. And today, this is what he got. I think it's a great film, fantastic film. Norman done a fantastic job. I've seen films in my life, boxing films, but this is special. Absolutely. Not because of me. Okay, and Joe, with the personality in it. But obviously, Vaughan made a special kind of documentary, which I think everyone around the world will see because of what he done. I give him 10 out of 10 for that.
I've been retired over 6 years ago. I've had a few film people approach me with scripts and this and that to do a feature film. But to be honest, I've not really been that interested. I'm a pretty private guy, but Vaughan Sivell, obviously the director, approached me with this opportunity. And that my question was, well, what's the story? You know, I've never lost 46 fights, you know, what's it about, you know? And when you're explaining about what he'd like to do and you can see his passion with it, about the family and so on, I was thinking, you know what, I'm proud, you know, I'm proud to show off my sons, my family, and, you know, to see where I come from humble beginnings, from nothing, being written off, being bullied in school, being injured, which, and that's things that people don't see. And, you know, I thought, yeah, let's do the story, you know. I've been out of boxing for like 4 years at the time, 5 years. Let's reflect on what I did, you know, and to cram everything in 90 minutes of 25 years of boxing, it's quite emotional. But I think he's done a good job, because I'm happy with my family, and I'm happy to see that, you know, and it makes me realise the love that I've had of my family. And if it wasn't for them, especially my dad Enzo, I never would have made it. So thanks to them, I am where I am right now. I can't explain 100%. My dad's a crazy Italian, and I'm obviously, I've got genes, I'm also a crazy half Italian. So, you know, he has such a passion for boxing. He has such a passion with me. And the thing is, I'm pretty laid back, but my dad's pretty fiery. So you also get days you don't want to go in the gym. And we'd argue worse than the married couple. So we'd argue. But what more important than arguing like a married couple, we would make up straight away. And he'd get the best out of me. So when I was pissed with him, I would basically go in the gym and smash the hell out of sparring partners, beat the hell out of everything else, and that's the way I used to be, you know. So people used to say to me, get rid of your dad, you know, he's a musician, never box. But I knew he was the perfect trainer for me, you know. And we developed our skills, and he started training me at the age of 9. When I wanted to quit boxing and I wanted to go parties, he's the one who pushed me to get out running. I hated it at the time, but thanks, Dad. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I am studying right now.
Who was the toughest competitor that you personally feel you ever were in the ring with?
That's a difficult one. I think, obviously, beating Chris Eubank, that was my toughest fight. It's the first time I ever done 12 rounds, but I knocked him down the first round. I thought it was going to be an easy night, but it wasn't. The season campaigner, Mikko Kessler, he was a warrior, you know, like Hopkins in a different way. So I met a lot of tough fighters, you know, and like I said, I'm blessed to be able to go through my career without a loss. Yeah, well, basically, everybody wants a film. I hope you really enjoy it. And thanks for your support all over the years. I really appreciate it, even after 6 years after retirement. And if you're not a boxing fan, I still hope you're going to enjoy it, because it's about family, about devotion, dedication, and love. So hope you enjoy it.